Good morning, students. Let's continue chapter 5. Today's topic is exercise 5.7. Now, student, find second order derivatives. For the second order derivatives, first, if y is equal to fx, then y double dash, it is represented second order derivative, or we can write f double dash x, or d square y by dx square, or y 2 and d 2 also. Okay, these are simple notation to represent the second order derivative. Now I'm starting the question. Okay, so here question number first, x square plus 3x plus 2. So first let y is equal to x square plus 3x plus 2, and then find dy by dx, differentiating with respect to x. Okay, so here also d by dx, x square plus 3x plus 2, you will get 2x plus 3, derivative of 2 is 0. And now for second order derivative, it is d square by dx square, and here d by dx of 2x plus 3, derivative of 2x, it's 2, and derivative of 3 is 0. So answer is 2 only. Move for the next question, question number 2. Here y is equal to x raise 20. So dy by dx, okay, first order derivative, it is 20 x raise 19, and now again d square y upon dx square means d by dx of 20 x raise 19. 20 is constant, and derivative of x raise 19, it is 19 x raise 19. So it is 380 x power 80. Okay, it is d square by y dx square, and it is known as second order derivative. For the question number third, here let y is equal to x cos x, first order derivative dy by dx. So here d by dx of x cos x, apply the multiply rule. First, x as it is derivative of cos x, it's a minus sin x, okay, and now plus cos x as it is derivative of x, it is a 1, okay, and now again differentiating and getting d square y by dx square. Here d by dx of minus x sin x plus cos x. Okay, so first for the term minus x sin x, apply the product rule. You will get first minus x is, as it is derivative of sin x, it is cos x. Then plus sin x as it is derivative of x, it is 1. Okay, plus now derivative of cos x, it is minus sin x. So you will get minus x cos x minus sin x, and here also minus sin x. So minus 2 sin x. Okay, it is the second order derivative. Now students, I am going to solve question number 5. Okay, to solve this, here let y is equal to x cube log x. Okay, so first find dy by dx. Here d by dx of x cube log x, multiply root, apply here. First x cube as it is derivative of log x, it is 1 by x. Then plus log x as it is derivative of x cube, it is 3x square. Okay, so here
x square plus 3x square log x. Okay, you can write x square 1 plus 3 log x. And now find the second order derivative d by dx of x square 1 plus 3 log x. Okay, and now again apply the product rule. So d square by dx square is first x square as it is d by dx of 1 plus 3 log x, and now 1 plus 3 log x write as it is, and derivative of x square you will find x square 1 is constant, derivative is 0, and from this term it is 3 into 1 by x. Okay, and here 1 plus 3 log x is as it is, derivative of x square is 2x. Now you will get 3x plus, from here it is 2x, and plus 6x log x. So answer is 5x plus 6x log x. You may take common x. So 5 plus 6 log x. It is second order derivative. Okay. Now move for the next question. I am taking question number 7. Okay. So first of all, to solve the question number 7, let y is equal to e raise 6x into cos 3x. First order derivative d by dx. Here d by dx of e raise 6x cos 3. Okay. Now apply the product rule. E raise 6x write as it is. Here derivative of cos 3x, then plus cos 3x, write as it is, derivative of e raise 6x. It is e raise 6x, derivative of cos 3x minus sin 3x, and now derivative of 3x is 3, plus cos 3x, and derivative of e raise 6x, e raise 6x, and derivative of 6x is 6. So it is minus 3. E raise 6 is a common. Okay. So first you can write e raise 6x. Here it is minus 3 sin 3x plus 6 cos 3x. Okay. It is the first order derivative. And now for the second order derivative, d square y dx square, it is d by dx of e raise 6x, and here minus 3 sin 3x plus 6 cos 3x. Okay, and again apply the product rule. Okay, e raise 6x write as it is, and derivative of minus 3 sin 3x plus 6 cos 3x. Okay, then plus minus 3 sin 3x plus 6 cos 3x write as it is, and derivative of e raise 6x. Now e raise 6x as it is. Okay, derivative of sin 3x, it is cos 3x. Okay, and then derivative of 3x, it's 3. So here 3 3s are 9, and it's cos 3x. Okay, plus here derivative of cos 3x, it's minus sin 3x, and derivative of 3x is 3. Okay, then plus, now students, minus 3 sin 3x write as it is, 6 cos 3x write as it is, derivative of e raise 6x is as it is, e raise 6x, and now derivative of 6x, it is 6. Now simplify, e raise 3x, take a common, and from here it is minus 9 cos 3x, and here minus 18 sin 3x, and here it is minus 18 sin 3x, and plus 3, 6, 6, 36 cos 3x. Okay, so finally you will get e raise 6x, and here minus 9 cos 3x and 36 cos 3x, you will get 27 cos 3x minus 18 and minus 18. Okay, so it is 36 sin 3x. Okay, it is the second order derivative, d square y by dx square. Now student, move for the next question, and I am going to solve question number 10. Okay, so first of all, let y is equal to sin log x. Okay, so first order derivative dy by dx, so it is d by dx sin log x. Okay, so derivative of sin x, it's cos log x. Okay, now derivative of log x, it is cos log x, and derivative of log x is 1 by x. Okay, now for the second order derivative d by dx of cos log x into 1 by x. Okay, now we can apply the product rule. Cos log x, take first function, and 1 by x as second function. So for d square y dx square, first cos log x write as it is, and derivative of 1 by x, then plus 1 by x write as it is, and derivative of cos log x, it is cos log x, derivative of 1 by x, it is minus 1 by x square, and here 1 by x is as it is, derivative of cos log x, it is minus sin log x, and now derivative of log x, it is 1 by x, so it is minus cos log x minus sin log x, and in the denominator it is x square. Okay, it is second order derivative. Here student, you may apply the division rule also, taking cos log x fx and x as gx. So apply fx by gx rule. Okay, now let's do the next question. Question number 13 student. Okay, here y is given, and we have to show that x square y2 plus xy1 plus y is equal to 0. Y1 means first derivative of y with respect to x, and y2 is second order derivative of y with respect to x. Okay, so first of all, find dy by dx. Okay, first order derivative. Here dy by dx of 3 cos log x plus 4 sin log x. Okay. And now, derivative of 3 cos log x. 3 is constant, write as it is. Derivative of cos log x minus sin log x. And now, derivative of log x, it is 1 by x. Okay. Plus, derivative of sin log x, it is cos log x. And derivative of log x is 1 by x. Okay. So, it is minus 3 sin log x plus 4 cos log x and here by x. Now, student, first do the cross multiplication. Okay. So, here it is x dy by dx is equal to minus 3 sin log x plus 4 cos log x. Okay. And now find the differentiation with respect to x. Okay. So here in left hand side we have to apply the product proof. So first x as it is, derivative of dy by dx is d square y by dx square. Now plus dy upon dx is as it is, derivative of x is 1. Okay. And on right hand side, derivative is minus 3 and cos log x, derivative of log x, 1 by x, then plus 4 as it is. And here minus sin log x and derivative of log x is 1 by x. And again, here it is x in denominator. We can do cross multiplication. So you will get x square d square y upon dx square plus x dy upon dx. And here it is minus 3 cos log x and here it is also minus 4 sin log x. Okay students, and here minus take common, you will get 3 cos log x plus 4 sin log x. And now see, it is y. Okay, given in the question that y is equal to 3 log cos x plus 4 sin log x. Okay, so it is minus 1. And here x square d square y upon dx square plus x dy upon dx. And in the last step, it is x square d square y upon dx square plus x dy upon dx plus y is equal to 0. Okay, you can write hence. Now students, question number 14. Okay, so here y is given and we have to show that these terms. So first find dy upon dx. Okay, it is d by dx of a e raise mx plus b e raise mx. Okay, so it is a is as it is e raise mx and derivative of mx is m. Here b is as it is e raise nx and now derivative of nx is n. Okay, and again d square y upon dx square. So here d by dx of a m e raise mx plus n b e raise nx. You will find a m square e raise mx plus b n square e raise nx. Okay. Now, we have the values of dy upon dx. Here d square y dx square. So substitute the values in this equation. Okay, it is a m square. I am substituting in this given equation. A m square e m x plus b n square e raise n x. Now minus here m plus n, right, as it is. And now value of dy upon dx. So here you have to write, it is a m e raise m x plus b n e raise n x. Okay, then plus m n and value of y. Y is a e raise m x plus b e raise n x. Okay, now students, simplify this equation. It is a m square e raise m x plus b n square e raise n x minus. Now multiply this. It is a m square e raise m x minus, here it is b n square e raise n x, and here it is minus b m n e raise n x minus a m n e raise m x. Okay, and now plus, multiply this bracket. It is m n a e raise m x plus m n b e raise n x. And now see that all terms cancel and you will get 0. Okay, so here you have to write substitute values. Okay, in given equation, it's the solution of this question.